to another episode of Airgun Detectives. This is part two of our special series where we're dedicating to Mike Melick and Flying Dragons air rifles. And as I said before, the only reason that I'm sharing this with you, I don't normally endorse airgun companies or specific airguns as far as to purchase, but I just felt I should allow you guys to know about this because they are some really good guns that are really good value, and you just might want to add one to your collection, but that's entirely up to you. All I am is I'm bringing you the information and you decide for yourself. But anyway, before we get started here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button if you hadn't already. If you would like to be notified of any of our new videos coming out, just hit that little bell. And once again, if you like what we're doing, if you like the direction we're going, please give us a thumbs up if you like what you're seeing. Okay, anyway, let's continue our series here with the Flying Dragon air guns, and specifically the Xisico air guns. These are Chinese imported air guns. And as I said before, Mike Melick, who is the renowned air gun tuner of these foreign air guns, he's terrific. He can tune any of these Chinese rifles, whether it be an Umarex brand that's from China, or which the majority of them are, by the way, or there's a Browning rifle I know that's under the Umarex umbrella. There's the Rugers, things of that nature. Anything from China, he can tune it, that's for sure. So anyway, let's talk about the PCPs. We covered the CO2s in the last version. Let's talk about one of these first. This one, I don't think Mike even puts this one out anymore, but I wanted to show it to you. This is a low pressure PCP. This one, you only have to fill this thing to 100 bar. Yeah, that's correct, 100 bar. And if it looks familiar, it should. It's basically the same exact foundation of the XX60, the Xisico XX60, the CO2 rifle. But what they did is you got a PCP chamber set up here. This is a low pressure PCP rifle too. It's only 1500 PSI or 100 bar. So that's all you have to fill this thing. And you get about 20 really good shots out of it. And the best part of it too is if you didn't want to put a lot of money into PCPs, you could actually use the pump to charge this up. It's much different of going up to 1500 PSI than trying to pump up one of your 3000 or your 200 bar PCP rifles. This one is obviously much easier to deal with. This can be adjusted whether if you want more power and fewer shots, or you want a little less power and more shots. Anyway, that can be set up. Yes, I refinished the rifle. It comes more looking like this. But as far as I added the Picatinny rail because I like shooting off the bipods and that type. So this is Mike Melick's design, and this is one of the first ones. I put the little suppressor on it because it is a little bit on the loud side, and you do get a little bit of that pinging sound. But I think I paid, if I remember correctly, I've had this for quite a few years. I paid less than $150 for this, for a PCP rifle. And you see how well it performs. So this was kind of the first one he came out with. And we're gonna, for fun, I'm just gonna show you how this one performs as well. One that he's currently carrying, and it keeps getting updated, is the Sentry here. And this design's changed a few times, and he continues to upgrade it. But this one has a magazine. This one, current one here, is in .177. They're actually making them now in .177, 22 and 25 caliber. But this one here has a 9-shot rotary magazine, and that tucks right in here. This is a bolt action, which is fine, and then your magazine just slides in, just like that. Boom, that's it. And these can be actually decocked too as well. You can hold this back, release the trigger here, and just slide the bolt forward, and you can actually decock the rifle. Very good trigger on these. We're going to test that out. We're going to show you. These get about 3 solid magazines, about 30 shots out of them. And this one you actually will fill. It's got a gauge on it, as you can see. This one goes to the full 200 bar, so it's a 3000 PSI. It's got rails on the side here, some Picatinny rails, if you'd like to mount something on the side. It's obviously got one on the bottom where I put the bipod. It's got a nice big rail across the top. It's simple, has your basic fill valve there, which is nice and simple. But a little adjustable cheek piece. And this is exactly how it came. The only thing I added was the optics, because these don't come with any type of optics on them. So no open sights. You can also, you can adjust the power on these yourself. It's that simple. You just, you right here, this has a little knob right here on the back. You just adjust that, and here's your window. It'll read. So you can set this up so if you want more shots, a little less velocity. I have mine just kind of set up in that sweet spot where this is shooting in the 800s, and I'm getting, like I said, 30 really good shots out of it. And shooting the heavier, the 10.65 grain pellets. So anyway, these are very reasonable. Less than $300, somewhere in the $250 range, I believe. They vary. Sometimes they'll run a special. It just depends. So let's see how well these PCP perform, and then we'll come back and we'll chat real quick. All right, we got our Mike Melick special, our Xisico XS60, but this is his PCP version. So let's see how well this does over the chronograph. We're gonna shoot the RWS, the 14.2 grain pellets. Let's just shoot five shots over the crony. Hopefully this thing will perform for us, the crony that is. And let's see what type of velocity we get. Let's see, shot number one, 840. Shot number two, 878. Shot number three, 875. Shot number four. Should be working our way up a little bit on our power curve here. Okay, shot number four, 871. Actually, no, we're pretty consistent here. This is good. And let's do one more shot. Shot number five, 856. Well, there you go. There's our five shots with the Mike Melick Special PCP. We have our Sentry PCP here. We're gonna see what type of feet per second we can get out of this. We're gonna go ahead and shoot the Barracuda Match, the 10.65 grain pellets. Let's just do five shots over the crony and see how well we do. Okay, shot number one. I think that was 816, let's see. Shot number two, 814. Shot number three, 815. Shot number four, 819. And shot number five, 817. Now that is some consistency. As we talked about before, you can adjust the power, and this is just dialed in just right. So that standard deviation was terrific. Let's move on to the next segment. We have our XS60, our PCP rifle. We're going to see what type of accuracy we get out of it. We're about 20 yards out, and let's just shoot five shots and see what type of grouping we have. We're going to be shooting the RWS Super Hollow Points, the 14.2 grain pellets. They seem to do pretty well in here. So let's see how this thing will group. All right. That's one. This is a Mike Melick Special, as I've mentioned numerous times. That's two. And here's three. That's three. And number four. Okay. That's four. And let's go with number five. There you go. There's five shots out of our little Xisico PCP rifle. Not too bad of groupings, if I do say so myself. All right, let's move on to the next segment. Okay, we got our Xisico, our Sentry, .177 caliber PCP rifle, and we're going to see how accurate we are. We're about 20 yards out, and let's shoot five shots and see what type of grouping we got. We're going to be shooting the 10.65 Barracuda pellets by H&N. They're a little heavier pellet, and this gun seems to do much better with the heavier pellets. So let's see what type of groupings we can get. All right. Shot number one. Shot number two. Shot number four. And shot number five. Ooh, that one moved on us a little bit. But that's our five shots for our Xisico Sentry .177 caliber PCP. So let's move on to the next segment. We got our custom-made Xisico, our XS60, but this is our PCP rifle put together by Mike Melick. And let's see what type of trigger weight we get when we do a little test here. We got our Lyman trigger gauge, and let's see how well we do. Okay. Oh, 1 pound, 10 ounces. Phenomenal trigger. Phenomenal. Let's move on to the next segment. All right, let's test our trigger weight here on our Sentry PCP rifle and see what type of weight we get out of the trigger. So I got my trusty Lyman trigger gauge here. Hopefully it won't fail me. And let's see what we get out of weight, folks. 13.3 ounces. You heard it here. You saw it here, 13.3 ounces, under a pound. That's pretty amazing. All right, let's move on to our next segment. Okay, we got our Xisico, our XS60 custom PCP rifle put together by Mike Melick. And let's see how well we do at 40 yards. A little windy today, but hopefully we can compensate for that. We'll be shooting the RWS, the 14.2 grain super hollow points. And then just give you an idea of how far back we are. We're sitting here, and our targets will be up here. There you go. Just at least gives you an idea. So let's see how well we do. We'll start with the right side and we'll work our way left. All right, that's a little bit. All right. And a little leg. All right, we have our little can there. And you know, I do have this disdain for diet soda. Never did like the taste of it, but they are useful for something. And there's our PCP XX60 by Mike Melick. Okay, now let's do a little plinking with our Sentry PCP rifle. We're at our usual distance for our long plinking with the rifle, about 40 yards. Let's show you that. As you can see where we're sitting now and what we're shooting at. There you go. Let's get back to where we're at. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to shoot the 10.65 grain. Those are the Barracuda, the H&Ns. So let's see how well we do. Like I said, we're 40 yards out. We're going to do our usual. We'll start at the right, work our way left, and see how we do. That's a one. It's always nice having the magazine here. Let's see. That's two. You can see this thing hits with some actually pretty good force, especially from this distance. Let's see what happens with the little pig there. Wow, that's a hit. And how about our little teeny piece of PVC there, 40 yards out. Well, we got a 2-for-1 on that one. We shattered the PCP and took care of the Diet Coke. So anyway, there's your Sentry PCP. I'd say it's pretty doggone accurate, especially at 40 yards. Let's move on to our next segment. Okay, let's wrap this up with our conclusion here real quick. And you saw how both these PCP rifles performed. Not too bad. And you saw the triggers on them. And you saw how we did plinking and our accuracy and all that. So they, overall, they did really, really well. I don't know if Mike offers this gun anymore. You would have to check with him. It's not on his website anymore, so I don't know if he's not building these anymore. But that's a very inexpensive beginner. Like I said, I think I paid less than $150 for this one. Now, our Sentry, this one keeps evolving. And Mike is very instrumental in actually the design and how this gun performs. He's constantly working with the manufacturers on making improvements and making some adjustments. Like they added this, the first series came out, didn't have the Picatinny rail on the bottom or the sides. That was all set up. So I believe they might even now have one that, if I'm not mistaken, even has a suppressor type on the barrel. So that's something that you might want to check on with Flying Dragons if this interests you at all. But what a fun gun. First of all, it's very unique looking. It's very comfortable to shoot. You saw what the trigger is. The trigger, I got this thing set for less than a pound. It's just amazing for a target trigger. You've got your magazines, which are kind of your typical spring-loaded magazines. The 177, they hold 9 rounds. Obviously, the 25 and the 22 hold less. You can actually adjust the power here. There's a power adjustment just by rotating this knob in the back, and that will put, obviously, it probably puts more pressure on the valve. It shoots out a little bit more air. But we're getting 30 really good shots out of it. We were shooting the 10.65 grains. Overall, pretty neat rifle. Pretty neat rifle. And again, I just want to emphasize, Mike does provide a really good product, and the customer service is second to none. This guy's outstanding. Or if you have a Chinese gun, you're having issues with it, maybe you want it tuned, he's a good option for you. Mike Melick. And like I said, he's been in this industry forever, and he is the godfather of air guns. And that's why I'm dedicating this episode to him and the Flying Dragons. So with that, overall, I'm going to give this, this also is going to get 4.25 stars, because I think just for the price of it, the style, the uniqueness, the accuracy, you can't beat it. It's really a fun gun. So with that, please stay tuned for future episodes of Airgun Detectives, and until next time, take care.